YouTube, in today's really cool color grading tutorial, well, actually today is going to be video editing tutorial, I'm going to talk about how you can deal with the dead pixels on your camera. Now, what I'm going to talk about is going to apply evenly on pretty much any editing software. We're talking about Premiere, After Effects, Final Cut, Avid, I mean, you name it. This is absolutely the same technique that goes to any of those video editing programs. Anyways, so here I have a file. I don't know how YouTube compression is, but I specifically created a couple dead pixels to simulate the faulty of the camera sensor. So we have one over here, and then we have a couple pixels over here. Now, most likely, if you have those couple pixels, you're going to be working on the entire project. Oh yeah, and by the way, and there's one right over here. So this all already graded. I put my origami LUT on it. So this clip is already graded. Now, the very important part you need to understand. In DaVinci Resolve, and this is apply on about adjustment layers in Premiere and other layer-based programs. This is a node-based, but the concept again is the same. So we have two little options over here. We have timeline, and then we have clip. Basically, the clip is the local adjustment. That means you're only editing this clip. However, if you're working on the project and you have dead pixels, most likely you're going to have the same dead pixels across all your shots if you used the same camera. So what we're going to do, we're actually going to be working in the timeline. In, for example, Premiere equivalent, this would be an adjustment layer. Or let's say you can duplicate a layer in certain situation and mask it out. But for the sake of it, this is adjustment layer. So let's create a new node, Alt-S, okay? Now, I'm going to do another new node because I don't really like touching the first node, okay? Another Alt-S, and then we're going to do Alt-P. We're going to convert it to the parallel. So here is a very simple fix. All I'm going to do now, I'm going to zoom in to a dead pixel, okay? I'm going to go into the mask, and again, every editing program have exactly same amount of tools at your disposal, and some of you probably going to say, oh, there's a plugins, whatnot. Sure, sometimes, actually a lot of times, those plugins not really doing that good of a job. Also, if you working on relatively heavily editing project with, you know, some sound adjustments with like multiple layers, whatnot, you don't really want to overload your computer with extra plugins because plugins take a lot of resources. This is the best and easiest way. Okay, so here I am in the Windows, and I'm gonna go and grab this little guy over here. Actually, any of them works, but I'm gonna do my own. And what I'm gonna do, just select this pixel right over here. Okay, for the sake of it, we're going to feather it a little bit, and we're going to do a little bit outside. Okay, now we're going to go over here into blur panel, and we're just simply going to blur it out until this thing disappears. Now, why is it not happening? That because we have soften. If we're going to go down a little bit, because it's such a small size, when you soften it, you make it radius too big. Now, when we go down a little bit, let's see. I don't know if you can see it over here. Probably not. Okay, we're going to see this thing disappear. All right, so that's it. Our dead pixel is gone. You don't need to track it. You don't need to do anything. Okay, now we're going to repeat the process for this. It's very same. Sometimes the dead pixel is going to be white. Sometimes they may be red. It depends, but most likely it's going to be either white or red. All right, so here's another one. Again, we're going to do this little square. You can have circle, whatever you want. Okay, make it disappear and slightly feather it, just slightly. Just in case, you know, you never know what kind of shot you have. You don't want anybody to notice this. Again, I'm going to add more, Alt-P. Going to zoom out. Here's a couple more guys, and it's very important, be sure to do one dead pixel per node. Don't try to jam them together. That way you have ultimately complete control on what you're doing. Now, this relatively is so small, you're not actually affecting quality at all. Okay, especially if you have 4K clip. This is 4K source rendered down to 1080p. And as we can see, it's actually working pretty good. Again, new node, new parallel layer. Okay, over here, like this, like that. Okay, couple pixels fatter, then blur. Okay, we zoom out. And as we can see, we fix the whole thing with just a few clicks of a mouse. That way, your computer is still running fast and you don't really need to do any kind of plugins or anything like that. So, thank you for watching. Be sure to click like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Stay cool.